18-year-old is in critical condition tonight. She was shot with a BB gun in her own apartment by a roommate. Live in the Newsplex with the latest on the case, KETV News Watch 7's Adrian Whitsett just back from Lincoln.
Brandy, 18-year-old Rachel Long went through surgery this morning to repair that artery torn by that BB. And while police look into the circumstances surrounding what they call an accident, they're also investigating a separate case at Long's apartment less than a half hour earlier.
In an instant, a Lincoln woman's trip out of her 25th and T apartment cut short.
She was walking out the door, her male roommate's BB gun misfired.
That BB slammed into 18-year-old Rachel Long's temple, cutting her temporal artery. While she's rushed to the hospital, police question why the gun went off.
I don't know exactly how the gun misfired. I just know that the male roommate was handling it, and that's when it went off.
Police confiscated two BB guns from the apartment, one belonging to Rachel Long's roommate, one belonging to her boyfriend. And police say they're investigating an entirely separate incident from that apartment not 30 minutes earlier.
According to Lincoln Police, a Marine corporal from this recruiting office less than two blocks from the apartment and 30 recruits ran past Long's apartment around 7:30. The corporal heard a whizzing sound and a ting, looked to the balcony and saw a man with a gun ducking back into the apartment. Officer Flood says they believe that shooter was Long's boyfriend, and police still haven't issued any citations on either incident, but they believe Rachel Long's dire situation emphasizes what they've said all along.
It illustrates the need to always handle firearms safely. I think people scoff and minimize the damage that BB guns can cause, but this is a clear example that it could have a life-altering damage.
Rachel Long's family just released a statement saying they choose not to comment at this time, but prayers for Rachel are welcome and appreciated. Brandy?
Adrian Whitsett, thanks.